Hey guys, today we're going to take a look at Xbox 360s, and we're going to use a heat gun to basically fix any of the Red Ring of Death errors that you may get from Xbox 360. And yeah, this is what it looks like. Okay, so as you can see, there's a Red Ring of Death. It's the first, third, and fourth quadrant lit up, which is basically a general hardware failure. There's another one where like two of them are lit up, and that means it's overheating. And if you check the info tab, I'll have a link to a site that has all the error codes in it that you can cross-reference for. But if you're getting a Red Ring of Death error, first, before you take it apart, make sure the video cable is connected properly. Take out the hard drive if you have a hard drive in. I already did that, but I know that the problem was with the Xbox and not the hard drive. What else could there be? Sometimes the Ethernet cable, if it's loose, it can generate problems. And as you can see on the screen, there's no output of any kind. Sometimes you'll get an error message on the screen when you turn it on, but that is not the case here. So, without any further ado, let's start on fixing the Xbox. So, we're gonna need a heat gun like this one. I picked this up at Home Depot for like 20 bucks. It's not very expensive. It goes up to, I forget what the temperature is. There's two settings, 750 Fahrenheit and 1000 degrees Fahrenheit. And so you need one that goes up to like at least 1000 degrees Fahrenheit. We're gonna need maybe some needle nose pliers. I just keep those around just in case. A flathead, mini, very small screwdriver. We need some heatsink compound. I got this from an electronics store in Fullerton called Orvac Electronics. This is it in its case. GC Electronics heatsink compound, type number 44, non-contaminating. You can find it on the internet or go to Radio Shack. They sell something called Arctic Silver, and you can pick some of that up. That'll work as well. But I prefer this just because it's, I don't know if it's cheaper, but I like it. The other things we'll need include rubbing alcohol. You're gonna need a T10. And a T9 torx screwdriver. So these are them. All of that said and done, let's start taking apart the Xbox. To take apart the Xbox, you're gonna need your small flathead screwdriver. Okay, so to start off, we're gonna take off this panel and this panel. And to do that, you need to take your little screwdriver and insert it into the little holes and push on these tabs, which basically allow this thing to pop off. So first, take your flathead, take out this little pad and stick it in there, and that will allow you to see, as you can see, it's kind of sticking up now. And you can pull it up like that. Good. And try not to let it come out, or go back in, I mean. And there's two of them. We're gonna have to do this to both sides. Okay, so now that we have these two, flip it over and do the same thing. Usually you can just pull it out if you get the other two. Otherwise you're gonna need to stick a screwdriver in this hole and kinda release the tab. But you shouldn't have to do that. So now you have that. Other side. You shouldn't have to take off a leg on this one, because it's above it. And keep your finger there. Push up on this tab, and this tab, and this tab. Now you have one side. Make sure it doesn't go down. And usually once you have most, like, three or four of them out, the other ones will pop out really nicely. So there's two. So now I have that and that. Okay, so what we're gonna do is pull the faceplate off now. And to do that, just kinda pry it off, like so. It kinda just pops off. And now, you'll see this. If this isn't intact, somebody's messed with your Xbox, but if it's your own Xbox and you haven't messed with it and it's not used, chances are it's gonna be there. Now that we're here, what you're gonna do is you're gonna pull up on these tabs, which are locking in place, including this one. This voids your warranty, by the way, so if your Xbox is still under warranty, send it into Microsoft and get it fixed for free. Unless you can do that, which, well, doesn't look like it really messed with the seal. Okay, so now, as you can see, it's kind of popping off, but in the back, it's still secured, and people say you're supposed to stick a screwdriver in there. That's not really necessary. All you have to do is just kind of pull it off, and it bends off. It won't snap, it won't break. I've done it about a million times fixing other people's Xboxes. And as you can see, there's these little tabs that you would push in, but it's not necessary. It takes a lot longer to do. So now, as you can see, we have the top. And the top is held on by some of these silver screws. Okay, so to start off, we're going to take off some of these silver screws. See, they're longer than these other ones. These are short ones, but you take off six screws, and that allows you to take off the top of the case and view the contents of the Xbox. Now, we're gonna take off these other screws too. Okay, so once you have those done, you can continue, I guess. Just take off the remainder of the screws. Okay, so some Xboxes use T9s. This one uses T8s for some reason, so I switched out the bit for a T8 Torx screw driver bit, and basically just take all these off. They're gonna be tight, most likely. Okay, so all the screws are out. Flip it over. Take the top off. And do that. Watch out for this little piece down here. It's the button. You can pull it off actually without breaking it. So you can see it's a little button piece. Now, this is the top of the Xbox. This is the inside of the Xbox. As you can see, it's kind of dirty. It's got, which kind is this? This is, I haven't looked at the drives in a while. Oh, it's a light on, Phillips light on. So yeah, we're gonna start off by taking out the drive, which you do by just, well, first disconnect these cables back here. SATA cable and the proprietary power cable for the drive. Then we're just gonna lift it up and out like this. So you can see it just kind of sits in there. So we'll set that over there. Now, after that, you can unplug the cables from the board. Just lay them over on the side. Next, take off the fan shroud, which basically, see, this is the fans right here, and this basically pushes the air through onto the heat sinks and allows it to be cooled. So, after we've taken off all that, we're gonna lift the board up and out. But before you do that, you have to take this off. This is the card that is used with the wireless controllers. So it also uses the T8 screw or T9. And so first you take that off, take this off. There's a screw hiding under there. And you'll unscrew it. Unscrew it. Unscrew it. And then you're just gonna unplug it. There's a little plug right there, it plugs in there. Just take it out and put it over to the side. Try to put that in a place where it's not gonna get any static electricity hitting it. So on something maybe wooden, or maybe put it in an ESD static bag. Okay, now that we've done that, we can lift the board out. And you're gonna unplug the fan, which is right here. Unplug the fan and pull the board out. And make sure that you ground yourself to the box by touching it before you actually grab the board. I mean, you kind of touch it no matter what, but just make sure you're grounded. Grounded basically means if you have any static electricity in your body and you touch circuits on a circuit board, the amount that it takes to feel a static shock is like, it's like I want to say a hundredth of that is what's necessary to damage components on a board. So basically just touch something metal, like a computer case or the Xbox case in this case, it'll get rid of, it'll dissipate that static, it'll take the static electricity that is in your body out, if that makes sense. Okay, so as you can see, if you flip it over, there are these four little pads. We're gonna take them off. They're little heat dissipators. These are RAM chips. And take these off. We're actually, if you want, you can use the penny trick on it. I guess I'll show you how to do that.
This is ridiculously painful. All right. Recording.
Okay. Okay, so basically what the penny trick is well, we're not going to do the full penny trick. What the penny trick is you take two pennies wrapped in electrical tape times four, so one for each RAM chip, and you basically take a little heat sink compound, thermal paste, put it on there, and then put the penny on. And what it does is it acts as a heat sink, and it's way better than these stupid little foam pads, because copper is a better heat conductor and it works better. Usually what you do with the penny trick is you put them on there, then you overheat your Xbox, and then you let it cool off, and then when it's cooled down, you turn it back on, and usually it works. But that does not permanently fix it, which is why we will use the pennies as heat sinks, but will not overheat it. We're actually going to use a heat gun on the whole board, but not that. Okay, so we're wrapping the pennies. Just take about that much tape, and you're gonna just stack them on top of each other, two pennies. So you need 8 pennies total if you're gonna do this, and you basically just wrap it like that, and then you take another length of tape, about the same length, and wrap it the other way, so that none of the copper is exposed. And like so. Okay. And you basically put a little paste on there, put on the RAM chip, and yeah. But we're not gonna do that yet. Now you're gonna need a flathead screwdriver. And what you're gonna do, if we push this over to the side a little bit for now, what we're gonna do is take off the heat sinks. See the two heat sinks right here and here are held on by those two X's, whatever they're called. So you're just gonna stick your screwdriver under, in between the little metal piece sticking out from the heatsink, and in between that and the end, and you're just gonna kind of pry it off. Okay, so kind of pry it off like that, and then you go to the other angle, not the one across from it, but the one at the other angle. And once you get that one off, try to be careful when you're doing this not to hit anything on the board. You don't want to knock anything off of it. Okay, there we go. And once you have two of them, it comes off pretty easily. So, as you can see, there's one X clamp. That's what they're called, X clamps, I forgot. And as you can see, the heat sink comes out. And there's that crappy thermal paste, which we will replace soon. I think we're gonna have to. So, once you get the second X clamp off, what we're gonna do is take the heatsink compound. Well, first we're gonna clean off the processor and the GPU. So, second X clamp off. They actually sell kits that you can buy, and it's basically new X clamps or something similar, where like some of them you have to drill into the board and then you put in new clamps, and they're supposed to work better, but I don't think it's really necessary. But you can just really bend them back and they work just fine. So yeah, now we have our processor here, and our GPU here. And what we're gonna do is take a screwdriver, a flathead, kind of just scrape this gunk off of it. Be careful though, while you're doing it, be gentle. And So you can see it's a lot of. So this is heat sink compound that Microsoft puts on it, and it's I don't think it really works that well since so many Xboxes have overheated. You know. So yeah, once you've done that, and let's do the other one. So yeah, you just basically scrape it all off, and then what we're gonna do is clean it off with the rubbing alcohol, and that should get rid of anything else on there. So you're gonna take your Q-tip, dip it in the alcohol, or if it's not high enough, obviously just get the tip of it wet, not dripping wet, but wet. Basically just gonna clean off the surface of the processor and the GPU. And you could also do this instead of scraping it off first, just do this, but I think scraping it off kind of gets more of it. So, yeah, you just want to kind of try to make it shinier. And the reason we can use this is because, well, the rubbing alcohol is that it doesn't ruin electrical components, whereas water would be ridiculously bad for it. So, okay, so once we've cleaned off the heat gunk from the CPU and the GPU, you can also clean it off of these, off the heat sinks if you want. Just dip it in there and just kind of get some alcohol in there. Maybe take a little rag. It won't come off, it's not that big of a deal. Because you're gonna put new heat sink on there. Anyway, you can also scrape it off with a screwdriver or a scraper, which might be more appropriate. Yeah. Okay, so now that we've done that, we're going to heat gun the board because there's nothing on it, and you never heat gun the top. Some people say it works better if you heat gun the top and the bottom, or heat gun the top, but you have to cover all the little components up with, you have to cover them all up with foil and putty, and it's just a big mess. It's better to do it on the bottom. So what we're gonna do, you have to make sure it's level while you're heat gunning it. So find somewhere you can place it, like on top of the case, for instance. This works, and I'd say it's pretty level. If you want to be super accurate, you take out a level and place that on there. And look at that, it's level. Okay. So, yes, it's done.